point number, you know, we completed up to this point number 10. Use of abstract method and concrete methods. Can I hope you remember when to choose abstract method, when to choose concrete method? If method implementation logic is changing from one subtype to another subtype, in a super class, we must declare the operation by using abstract method so that we can force the subclass developer to implement that operation according to subclass requirement. If an operation implementation logic is common to all subclasses, we must create that operation by using concrete method so that subclass programmer can reuse it. Okay, so then we have taken example shape object and bus object. In shape object, now the operation find area logic is changing from one type of shape to another type of shape. Then we have to declare this find area method in shape class as a abstract method. I taken bus class. In a bus class, we have breaks method. Breaks method implementation is common to all subclasses. Then in bus class, we have taken that method as a concrete method. Okay. Then today, let us try to complete remaining types of method, little heavy. Okay, now static, non-static, private, non-private, void, non-void, parameterized, non-parameterized. Okay. So these four types of methods concept is little heavy, heavy topic. Are you ready to understand? Ready to participate? Did you complete videos on variable chapter? Did you watch variable chapter videos completed? Tell me. I created a variable as a static. Then what happened? What compiler do? What JVM will do? If I create a variable as a static, what compiler and JVM will do? Come on. If you declare variable as a static, what will happen? Compiler JVM feels that, okay, it's a static. It has one copy memory. JVM will provide one copy memory, right? Then in all methods of current class, we can access that variable directly by its name. Yes or no? Now I'm taking like this, like static variable. We also have static method. Also we have non-static method. Okay, now static method, non-static method. What is a static method? What is a non-static method? A method that is declared with the keyword static is called static method. A method that is declared without static keyword is called non-static method. Point number one. Point number two. If you declare a method as a static, we can access this method and execute its logic without creating object, because static method not meant for executing an operation for object. Static method meant for executing an operation common to all methods, common to all objects. Non point, it's not a new point. Repeating again, when you declare a variable or method as a static, it is meant for not storing values specific to an object. Static method not meant for executing logic specific to one object. Static variable meant for storing value common to all objects. Static method meant for executing logic to perform one operation common to all objects. For example, let me give an example. Do you remember bank example? We have taken bank name, branch name, IFSC. Tell me, I want to store values inside bank name, branch name, IFSC variables. you must store values in these three variables specific to one object or common to all objects. Common to all objects. Then I want to display those three variable values specific to one object or common to all objects. Common to all objects. Then I must declare that methods, storing values method, display values method. You must declare as static or non-static. Static. If you declare method as a static, do we need object to call that method? No, because static method logic is not meant for executing specific to one particular object. Did you understand my point? It is not meant for executing logic particular to one object. Okay, then tell me now. If you declare method as a non-static, what does it mean? Non-static means execute for object. Execute for object. Now tell me, if you take account number, account holder name, balance, these three values specific to one object, na? For Hari Krishna object, separately should initialize. For a Balai Babu object, you have to initialize separately. For, you know, Pawan Kalyan object, you have to initialize separately. And you have to read value separately. That means the method you are, the logic you are developing to perform one operation, want to be executed for specific to one object, then we must declare that method as non-static method. So what is static method? What is non-static method? Why static method? Why non-static method? Okay, now come on, try to recollect all these 4 points once again. A method that is declared with the keyword static is called static method, or a method that has static keyword in its declaration is called static method. A method that doesn't have static keyword in its declaration is called what? Non-static method. Static method is used for developing logic and execute that logic without object. Static method used for developing logic, execute that logic common to all object, not for any specific object. Non-static method is used for developing logic common to all objects. Remember this point. Non-static method is used for developing logic common to all objects, but execute the logic specific to every object separately with the values available in that object. Okay. Did you understand my words? I am not talking about memory. Methods are not meant for memory. Methods are not meant for storing values. Methods are meant for executing logic. If it is a variable, you must talk memory. Static variable is used for providing memory common to all objects, to store value common to all objects. But methods are not meant for allocating memory. Methods are meant for executing logic, na? Should talk from execution logic point of view. Static method is used for developing logic common to all objects and also used for executing the logic common to all objects. Whereas non-static method is used for developing logic common to all objects, but execute logic specific to every object separately with the values available in that object. For example, if you take bank account application, for storing values in static variables, for reading values from static variables, account number, account bank name, branch name, IFSC variables, we must create static method, because now the method logic is working for static variables. Static variables are common to all objects, not specific to any particular object. So static method we have to create. Next, if you take if you want to create a method to store values in non-static variables and read values from non-static variables, you must create the method as a non-static method, because non-static variables will be provided separately, will be provided memory separately in every object. So to execute this method logic, I need what? Object. Non-static variables memory available in object. To execute this method, I need object. Everybody got clarity? Yeah? Are you visualizing what I am telling? Are you visualizing whatever I am telling? So I'm again repeating what, why. What is static method? Why static method? Okay. What type of variables we can access in static method? How to call and execute static method? Totally four questions. Totally four questions I have answered. Again, I'm repeating. What is static method? Why static method? What variables we can access in static method? And next, how to call and execute static method? Okay, four questions. Question number one, what is static method? A method that contains static keyword in its declaration is called static method. Why static method? Static method is used for developing logic and executing logic common to all objects. Third point, what type of variables we can access in static method? Inside static method, we can access only static variables directly by their name. We cannot access non-static variables directly by their name, because non-static variables to execute, we need object. Because non-static variables are provided memory separately in every object. So from which object non-static variables to read, we need object to use to, we need object to access static variable. We need object to access non-static variable. Are you catching my point? Understand the point? I'm not writing any point intentionally on the screen, because if your mind is habituated reading the content I am typing, your mind never visualize. You will addicted to typing. If somebody type, then your mouth read, then your mind visualize. Change your mind. You have to visualize by listening. Because in company, team lead never write anything on the board. In company, client never write anything on the board while explaining. Okay, whenever a requirement is telling to you, people will talk over the phone. They never write anything on the board. They will ask, okay, Mr. Hari, I need, this is a requirement, what to do? While the client is talking about requirement, you must visualize the project architecture by your own and you should answer. Is it possible or not possible? If possible, how many days it will take? How many classes, logic, you have to write background, everything you should visualize. So this is also part of practice only. Are you catching my point? Are you catching my point? Array, M1 method is a static rabbi. Already we practiced it in the main method. M1 method, static and main method both are same. Tell me, can I access non-static variable directly by its name inside the main method? No, because main method is a static. Already we discussed this point. I'm repeating the same point with the M1 method. When I take M1 method, your mind is off. Array, M1 method, a static method, I'm not understanding. Crying like anything, Tumri fellows. Okay? If you practice earlier topics, it will be easy to compare and listen and visualize. Main method, M1 method, both are same. Inside main method, if you want to access non-static variable, what you did? You created explicit object and call. Why? Because main method is not called by using object. Yes or no? Main method is called directly by its name. There is no object. So when there is no object, from which object non-static variable should access? Correct? Huh? Tell me now. Inside M1 method, what variables are allowed to access? Inside M1 method, we can access static variables directly by their name, because static variables already has memory. But we cannot access non-static variable directly inside this method, because non-static methods doesn't have one copy memory. It has separate copy memory in every object. From which object the variables you wanted to access, that object reference you must use explicitly inside a static method. So final conclusion, inside static method, we can access static variable directly by their name, but we cannot access non-static variable directly by their name. Okay, na? Come on, apply the same thought in non-static method. What is non-static method? Why non-static method? How we must call non-static method? And what type of variables we can access inside a non-static method? Come on. A non-static method, a method that doesn't have static keyword in its declaration is called non-static method. Non-static method is used for developing logic common to all objects and execute logic specific to one object. Then non-static method is meant for execute logic to perform an operation for one particular object. You must call non-static method by using object. If you call non-static method without object, compiler will throw error. Then inside non-static method, what type of variables are allowed to access? You are allowed to access both static and non-static variables directly by their name. Hey, confusion. Inside static method, you are allowed to access only static variables directly by their name. You are not allowed to access non-static variable directly by their name. If you try to access, compiler throw error. Because static method doesn't take any object. Because static method doesn't meant for executing for object. Non-static variables are meant for object. So static method doesn't execute for object. Hence, you cannot access non-static variable directly by their name inside static method. But if you take non-static method, you can access both static variables and non-static variables. How is it possible to access static variables? Because static variables already have memory, na? And how is possible to access non-static variables? Non-static variables you can access because this M2 method accessing by using object only, na? In that object, non-static variables memory available. Yes or no? Let us put all these points, all these 8 points in a program. Now, first we completed what is a static method, what is a non-static method, why static method, why non-static method. Then how to call? Look at the test class main method. I want to call M1 method. M1 method is a static. Already it has memory and object is not required. It is available in memory with which respect to example class. Then I'm calling example.m1. Then can I call M2 method by using class name? M2 method is what method? Non-static. Non-static means it is meant for executing logic for an object. Tell me now. Can I access by using class name? No. Compiler will throw error for M2 method call. Next. I have created object. Tell me, using object can access static method? Using object can access static method? Yes. Because static method is meant for executing logic common to all objects. So you can access static method either by using class name or by using object. But the meaning is here, e1.m1 when I call, is this m1 method executing for e1? Is e1 is taking by this m1 method? No. Hello, this point is very, very important. e1.m1 method, when you call explicitly, compiler software remove this e1, place here what? Example dot. So this example.m1, e1.m1, both are same implicitly. Compiler doesn't use e1 here. Compiler use what? Class name only, example dot. So m1 method doesn't receive, m1 method doesn't receive this e1 object, and e1 object inside logic it cannot use. Whereas if you call m2 method, e1.m2 method when you call below, M2 method receiving this E1 object inside this M2 method logic. When you call E1.M2 inside method logic, we can access E1 object internal available non-static variables, because M2 method is meant for execute logic for the object. Did you understand my terminology? Am I going fast? Are you accepting my words? Are you comfortable? Should I go slow? Did you understand all points? When you call a method by using, when you call static method by using object, this object will not come into M1 method. Inside M1 method logic, we cannot use E1
object. Hello.
Data means non-static variables we cannot access. When I write e1.m2, e1 object is going into m2 method. Inside m2 method, if you access non-static variables, those non-static variables are accessing from this e1 pointing object. Compile successfully, wrong. Then come to that, I have created one static variable, non-static variable. Inside static method, I am accessing static variable, and inside non-static method also I am accessing static variable. Any compile time error? No, because static variable already has memory. Static variable already has memory, we can access it. Then can I access non-static variable inside a static method? No, because non-static variable has a memory not in the class. It is available memory inside object. In which object it is available? That object reference you must use. So there are two people should use the reference, either programmer you explicitly to use, or compiler should place the reference. Compiler doesn't place reference before x variable because the method is static and doesn't receive this e1 object. Are you catching my point? Whereas if you take non-static method, inside non-static method, if you access x variable directly, no problem. Compile successfully. Why it is compiled successfully? Because when you call M2 method with object, then this object reference is passed into M2 method. Implicitly, the reference is placed to X variable. X variable is reading from this current object. So final conclusion, inside a static method, what variables I can access, what variables I cannot access. Inside a non-static method, what variables I can access, what variables I cannot access, and why. Are you ready to conclude all the points? Right, look at here. Static method we can access without using object. Then inside a static variable, static method directly we can access, but a non-static variable, non-static methods, you cannot access directly, compiler throw error. If you need to access non-static variable, non-static method inside a static method, you must use object explicitly. Next, we will access non-static method by using object. That object will come into non-static method. So non-static variables, non-static methods, you can access directly, so that these members will be accessing from that object. Right, look at this diagram now. Which type of method, static, non-static method, create recommendation and mandatory? Come on, sir. Come here, sir. Come back here. Come back here. Tell me, I wanted to ask one question. Carefully listen. Always I am creating non-static method. Is it recommended or not recommended? Always I am creating non-static method. Is it recommended or not recommended? Let me show you one small test case so that you will get clarity. I am creating one class like this, class A. Class A, open bracket, closed bracket. Then here I am writing void m1, open bracket, closed bracket. Just I am displaying system.out.println. System.out.println double quotes. Just I am writing hi. Just one SOP in there. Now I am creating one more method called M2 method. One more method called M2 method. System.out.println. I am writing one local variable I am taking. Okay, local variable int x equal to 10. Now just I am displaying that local variable. Let me take p here. Okay, p, and I am writing here p variable. Okay. And next, I'm taking one more variable here. Now this time the p is not a local variable, it is a parameter variable, int p. Okay, and next I'm creating one static variable. You can create static variable anywhere, int a equal to 10, int a equal to 10. And now I'm writing one method, void m4, void m4, open bracket, closed bracket. Now I'm writing here system.out.println of system.out.println of that A variable I am accessing and displaying. This is the program I have written, buddy. Now I am expecting you to answer. Is this a right design program or wrong design program? Expecting answer from all people. Is it right design or wrong design? Class test, open bracket, closed bracket, public, static void main of, string array args. Now tell me, I want to execute, okay, I want to execute that m1, m2, m3, m4 methods from test class. Can I call them by using class name a.m1? Come on, I'm going little fast, expecting you to give answer fast. m2, a.m2, a.m3 with value 50, a.m4. Can I call? I'm going very fast. You have to catch my speed. Today, I'm not behaving like a faculty. Today, I'm behaving like a team lead. Today, I'm behaving like a client. Okay, if you are, you have to behave like a team member. You are behave like a project developer so that you can understand. If you are a student, like, okay, or I'm say looking at the screen, looking that side, looking this side, coming back, sir, not understand. I'm not a sir to repeat. Can you ask the client to repeat? Come on. Can you ask the client to repeat? When client is telling the requirement, can you ask, hey, come again, Rabbi, I'm not understand. Then immediately client will call to your manager and say, tomorrow if I see Hare Krishna in my team, I will murder you. Tell me, is it possible to call this M1, M2, M3 methods directly by using class name? No. Why? Because they are non-static methods. When you create method as a non-static method, I need an object. A1 equal to new A. If I write A1 equal to new A, A1.m1, you need to call all these methods by using what now? Object. A1. M1, M2, M3 of 50 and M4. Now program successfully compiled and methods are executed. Hey, try to question yourself and answer. Is it really required to create object to call these methods? Look at the methodologic. Inside methodologics, are you using any object here, object values? Sir, how can I know object using or not? Object means non-static variables. Inside a method logic, are you accessing any non-static variables? No. Are you accessing any non-static variable? No. Are you accessing any non-static variable? No. Are you accessing any non-static variable? No. Non-static object required for what? To allocate memory for non-static variable. So now A1 variable pointing to this object. So tell me, A1 variable 4 bytes of memory, object 8 bytes of memory, and consuming some time 12 bytes of memory plus some time it is consuming. Tell me, this 12 bytes of memory and time is a waste or not? And next, this reference is passing into every method, that passing for passing purpose some memory, 4 bytes of memory will be consumed and some time will be consumed. Totally 12 plus 4, 16 bytes of memory and time will be consumed. It's everything is waste, na? Bolo. If I declare these methods as static. If I declare all these methods as static, I am not required to create object. I can directly call by using class name. All the 16 bytes of memory and time will be saved because I no need to create object. So final conclusion, tell me, static method creation, is it rule or recommendation? Expecting answer. Many people don't have common sense. It's the time you need to get clarity. Static method creation in the project, rule or recommendation? Recommendation. If you create static method, then what will happen? You will get memory and time will be saved. Tell me, can I create static method always in the project? Oy, no. Can I create static method always in the project? No. When I should create method as a non-static, whether as a static method? I am taking one variable int x equal to 20. Now here I am writing void m1 method. Okay, inside M1 method, I am taking system.out.println of. Everyone answer. System.out.println. Just I am displaying message hi. Tell me, this M1 method, okay, M5 method. This M5 method should be static or non-static? Can be static, can be non-static. Recommended is static. So that we can call this method by using class name. Object is not required to create. Tell me, if I create one local variable here, int p equal to 50, and then I'm displaying system.out.println p. Tell me, this M5 method must be static or non-static? Can be static, can be non-static. Recommended is static. Are you understanding my words? Are you understanding my statement? Please concentrate. Please try to connect to my statement. Don't show your confusion talent here. Please recommend, please try to connect to my subject. Next, I'm writing here system.out.println of static variable I am accessing. Then tell me, this method can be static, can be non-static. Okay, but recommended is static, so that I no need to create object. I can call directly by its name or by using class name. Now the danger story. I am accessing non-static variable below. Now it can be static or non-static? No, it must be non-static. It must be non-static. Why? Inside static method, we cannot access non-static variables directly by their name. Now, because of this SOP Linux, this method must be non-static method. Sir, generally in your academics, you have by hearted. If you want to execute method by using object, it should be non-static method. If you want to execute method without object, we must create that method as a static method. Yes or no? In your academics, you by hearted a statement. Even you take any textbook, it's a challenge. It's a challenge to you all, 1 crore better. The points what I have addressed here, you don't find anywhere. You take any textbook, any website, any trainer, any faculty, any lecturer you take, people will give you one statement blindly. What is that? If you want to execute a method with object, create it as a non-static method. If you want to execute a method logic without object, create it as a static method. Wow, making you by-hearted that point. Not making you understand the meaning of behind. With object, without object, meaning is what? inside a method logic, if you are accessing non-static variable, then this method should execute with object, because non-static variable memory available inside object. Inside method logic, if you are not using non-static variable, then object is not required, because there is no non-static variable. So that is the point, sir. That is point is not addressing by anybody. Why? Because this much time should spend. It's very complicated to make you understand this point like this. It's very complicated. Okay, it's very very complicated to make you understand. That's why generally people will not take the risk. Let me tell one statement. People remember later. Automatically they will understand. Okay, automatically they will understand later. You will not understand. You habituated. If your interview asks the question, why I should create this method as a non-static? If I create a static, what is the problem? So if interview asks this twist questions, then you cannot answer. Sorry, my sir told only one point. I am following. If you want to execute method with object, create it as a non-static. If you want to execute a method without object, create it as a static. But if you learn like this, your explanation, the presentation of the subject will be different. What do you say? Are you understand this point? Did you enjoy? Simple point. I have another question, Rabbi. If you wanted to call this method with the object, how do you know as a developer while developing, how can you take the decision this method should execute with object or without object? From the developer point of view, you have to answer, not from the caller point of view. Caller cannot decide the method creation. Method developer should decide the type of the method. Are you catching my point? Inside a method logic, if you're required to access non-static variable, then create this method as a non-static method, so that you are forcing the user programmer to create object and call this method. When you create object, your non-static variables are provided memory, and using this object method is called method internal logic. The non-static variable value reading from the object, so execution is smooth. Everyone understanding? I'll give you more clarity in the next chapters. Okay, more depth topic is, depth programming is there in the next chapters. At this minute, only I'm talking top level. More depth with the JVM architecture, horrible stories are there in the next chapters. Okay, now let me conclude. Which method always we can create? Non-static method. Either you access non-static variable, static variable, local variable, no variable, you can create always non-static method. But non-static method is always recommended to create? No, because it consumes more memory and time to execute. Is it recommended to create static method always? Again, no. If non-static variable you are using inside a static method, compiler throw error. Static method creation is a recommendation and non-static method creation is rule. Hello, did you understand? So tell me conclusion, when to create method as a static, when to create method as a non-static. Inside method logic, if we are accessing non-static variable, we must create it as a non-static method. If inside method logic, we are not accessing any non-static variable, then never ever create that method as a non-static, create it as a static method. So now I'm going to conclude the point. Recommendation, which type of method, static or non-static creation is recommended and mandatory. Static method creation is recommended, non-static method creation is mandatory and rule. Now look at there, I'm giving some combinations. In this combination, what type of method you must create? Inside the method logic, I'm accessing only static variables. What method you should create, static or non-static? Static. Is it rule or recommendation? Recommendation. Now inside method logic, only non-static variables I am accessing. Then what type of method I should create? Non-static. Recommendation or rule? Rule. Okay. Next, inside method, I am using both static variable, non-static variable. Then tell me, which type of method you should create, static or non-static? You must create non-static. Recommendation or rule? Recommendation or rule? Rule. You cannot create static method. In case number three, in case number one, case number two, in case number one, you can create as a static, non-static, but static is recommended. In case number two, you can create only non-static method and it's a rule. In case number three also, you can create only non-static method. It's a rule because non-static variable involvement is there. Case number four, we have parameter variable and local variable I'm accessing inside a method. Below, it's a static or non-static? Static. You can create as a static, also can create as a non-static, but static is recommended. Inside a method, I'm using static variable, parameter variable, local variable. Any of the three variables I am accessing, then tell me. You can create method as either static or non-static, but recommended is static because time will be saved. I'm accessing all four types of variables, then must be non-static because non-static variable is there, it's a rule. No variable I'm using, just SOPLN. You can create method as a static and also as a non-static, but recommended is static. Next, empty method, no logic, just open bracket, closed bracket, then create it as a, you can create as a static or non-static, but recommended is static. Am I going fast? Did you understand? So, this is the syllabus of static, non-static method, all points. You answer by your own. I am giving you 2 to 3 minutes time. You read all 7 questions of static, non-static, answer by your own. And then I will answer. Let's see your answers, my answers matching or not. Right, all are you ready for answering? Let's start answer all these questions. First question, a method that has static keyword in its declaration is called static method. A method that doesn't have static keyword in its creation in its declaration is called non-static method. Static method is used for developing logic common to all objects. And if you don't use any non-static variable inside the static method, we must use the method as static. If you are accessing non-static variable, and want to execute method logic specific to one object, you must create the method as what? Non-static method. Simple point, conclusion. Inside method development, if you are not using non-static variable, then you have to create that method as a static. Next, inside method logic, if you are accessing non-static variable, you must create that method as a non-static. Next, creating a method as static method, is it rule or recommendation? It is recommendation. Creating a method as a non-static method, is it rule or recommendation? It is a rule, because inside a static method, non-static variable is not allowed to access. Next, rule in creating static method. In creating static method, inside a method logic, we cannot access non-static variable or non-static method directly by its name. We must explicitly create object. Rule in creating non-static method. There is no rule in creating non-static method. We can access both static variable and non-static variable. Rule in invoking non-static method. Non-static method, to invoke non-static method, there is no rule. We can access by using its directly its name, by using class name, by using object. Rule in invoking non-static method. Non-static method must access only by using object. Okay, if you access directly by its name or by using class name, compiler will throw error. In what cases we must create a method as a static method? Inside a method logic, we are not accessing non-static variable. Then we should create method as a static method. In this case, we can also create as method as a non-static, but it takes it to call this method, we must create object. Object creation is taking some time and memory, which is waste, because that object is not used inside static method. In which case we must create a method as a non-static method? Inside a method logic, if you are using non-static variable, we must create this method as a non-static, so that when we call this method by using one object, this non-static variable value reading from that object. Sample program with static method, sample program with non-static method. So these are the common points. Now the eighth point is additional point. In a non-static method, if you access non-static variable directly by its name, from where this non-static variable is accessed, or from which object this non-static variable is accessed? From the current object, from the current object of this method. What the meaning of current object? The object using which you call this method. For example, deposit method, you call by using account one. Tell me, inside deposit method, logic will be what? Balance equal to balance plus amount, na? Then tell me, this 5,000 rupees is accessed and should add with the balance. Which object balance? Click on raise button. Click on raise button. Now the balance variable must access from account object. Which account object? Account one or account two? Account one. Why? Because this deposit method is accessed by using account one. Everyone understand? Because this method is accessed by using account one, so implicitly what is the statement available here? Account one dot balance, and here what? Account one dot balance. Now these are the fixed or dynamically applied. Now if I call account two dot balance, same logic is executing, but second time what is the reference is added dynamically? Account two dot balance, account two dot balance. So tell me now, if you access non-static variable inside a non-static method directly by its name, from which object non-static variable memory is accessed? From the current object using which this method is called. Common question, why we cannot access non-static variable from static method? Because static method is accessed directly by its name. And even though you access by using object, this object is not passed into this method. And how can we access non-static variable from non-static method directly when it doesn't have memory? When you take a non-static method, you must call this object by using object. This object reference is passed into this method. Then inside this method, using that reference, the non-static variables are accessed, executed from this account object. Can I hope everyone understand? Shall we develop the project now? Shall we develop the program, bank account application? We got clarity on how to create methods. as a static method, as a non-static method, and how to execute methods, you got clarity. So now I want you to develop this knowledge in a bank application. Ready? All right. Develop. I don't help, Ray. You should only develop. Develop bank application to perform deposit, withdraw, withdraw balance inquiry operations using program. In this project, you must create bank account objects with the below properties, with the below properties. Number one, bank name, branch name, IFSC, account number, account holder name, balance. To store values, read and display values in above variables. You must define methods. You must define methods. Also define business operation methods. What are the business operation methods? Deposit, withdraw, and current balance. This is the story, Baba. Simple code, I given it, expecting all the people write the program for it. I'm giving you 5 minutes time. 5 minutes is more than enough. Start right. After 5 minutes, I'll explain you. Then we'll see that your code and my code, how you written code and how I written code. What are the knowledge you gain here? This is static, non-static members point only. Just you need to apply. That's it. Nothing more. 5 minutes time I'm giving. Try to develop code.
एक बार हुआ था तुम उससे हाथ मिलाए थे, तुम्हारी मम्मी थी, तुम भी थे।
हम ऐसे बात कर रहे हैं, हम 2 साल में से मिल लिए होंगे, तुम्हारे दोस्त होंगे। हम ऐसे
याद अब आया है, एक बार हुआ था तुम उससे हाथ मिलाए थे, तुम्हारी मम्मी थी, तुम भी थे। याद अब आया है, एक बार हुआ था तुम उससे हाथ मिलाए थे, तुम्हारी मम्मी थी, तुम भी थे। जैसे कि तब जाके सब होता है, हम आपको मिला नहीं, वो अपना छोड़िए, तो हमारे भी कैरेक्टर से है ना, चला उसका ऐसा है वैसा है, तब जाके मुझे वो मायने की अच्छे से पता चला।
Did you complete it? First, what you need to type? 2 classes you need to develop, right? Bank and bank account. 2 classes we missed to type, right? Class bank account. In a object oriented programming basics, class object instance I told you. Whenever you want to create a program in Java, first you must question for which object you must develop the code. I want to develop object bank account. Then you must first decide its data, object and its data. Now its data is bank name. Bank name, branch name, IFSC, account holder name, balance. Right? Then next I told you in variable chapter. These variables storing the values common to all objects, declare them as static. Right? Static. Next, if you declare variables to store values separately for every object, declare them as non-static. Only data types, no keyword static there. Static double. Then next, when you create variables, if you take real world, we will perform several operations around these variables. Then to perform operations, we need to define methods, right? Tell me, what type of methods you have to take, either static or non-static? When should I create method as a static and when should I create method as a non-static? Inside method logic, you are not accessing non-static variables, then declare it as a static. It is recommended. If you create static, no need to create object. Okay, now tell me, static. Now I wanted to initialize these three variable values. For that, I am defining one method, static void. I can take method name m1, m2, m3. But if you take m1, m2, m3, you know, there is no meaning for it. I am developing the bank application. It's not example sample logic, right? So I need to take some proper name. I want to take the method name as set bank details. Okay, set bank details. The meaning of set in Java is store, initialize. Set bank details. Then I am accessing bank name equal to double quotes HDFC. Next, branch name equal to, I may repeat, okay. And next, IFSC equal to HD123AM. Okay, why have taken this method as static? Can I take it as a non-static? Come on. Can I take as a non-static? Can I am talking the word called can. Can I take method as a non-static? Come on, sir, understand my question. Can. I'm not asking will. Will means design. Can means rules. Can I take method as a non-static? Is there any compile time error? No. Semicolon expected. Where? Compile successfully. But it's a wrong design. Why? Unnecessary, I should create object. To set the bank details, why I need a bank account object? Bank details are common to all bank accounts. If you declare as a static, I can call this method common to all bank accounts. So inside a method logic, if you are not accessing non-static variable, no need to create object to call this method, declare as a static. Now also compile. Static is recommended. Next. I wanted to initialize these three variables. Tell me, these three variables are what type of variables? Non-static. Non-static variables, void. I can take M2 method, but M2 method is not a meaningful name. Operation, what operation? Set bank account details. Okay, this is the bank details and bank account details. Below, bank account details are changing from one bank account to another bank account, right? So it must be static or non-static? Non-static. Now here, I'm writing account number equal to 1234. Account holder name equal to, account holder name equal to double quotes, below, HK. And next, balance equal to let's say some 25,000. Now there is a small doubt here. All people carefully think. If I assign static variables directly HDFC Amirpet HD123AM, is there any problem? Is there any problem? No problem. There is a problem, but this project I am developing for only HDFC Bank. I am developing this project for all banks. I don't want to develop only specific to HDFC bank. Then what to do? I must not read values here. I should not assign values here. If I assign values here, what happen? Then these variable values are fixed. It will work only for HDFC bank. I must take the values from I must take values from user. I should not hard code. I must read values from user. Then what to do now? Here I must take parameters. Do you remember how can I take values from other program or variable chapter? Parameter. I told you today class is fully depending on variables chapter. String, bank name, string, branch name, string, IFS. Then here I am writing parameter bank name, branch name, IFS. Tell me now, this method is now dynamic code method. This method working common to all objects with the given values. Is it clear? Inside this method, I am accessing static variables and parameter variables. There is no non-static variable, so not required to declare it as a non-static method. Same thought apply here also. Below 1, 2, 3, 4 HK, and then 25,000 if we assign, then what happen? Now this method will become static nature, only work for HK. And you are starting one bank only to open account for Harikrishna only. No, right? You have to work for any object. So I have to take values from the user. For that, I have to write here what parameter long account number, string account holder name, double balance. Then here what I should write? Account number, account holder name, balance. Hello, all you people understand why I design the methods like this? First, I design this method as a static because it is working with only static parameter variables. I take in parameters because I want to take values from other programmer. Next, I take in this method as a non-static because this method contains non-static variable access. And I take in parameters because the values must take from other programmer. I should not hard code because I'm writing this class for all customers, all banks and all customers. Then tell me, initialization completed. Okay. The next one. Tell me now. I wanted to read values and display. To read and display values, you have to question yourself. Sometimes I want only bank name. Sometimes I want only branch name. Sometimes I want only IFSC. Then I have to define three methods separately. Static void, bank name, system.out.println of, system.out.println of, bank name. Sir, my target is only focusing on static, non-static. Other issues I am not going to handle here. What the current topic we discussing here? Only static, non-static methods creation. All people are asking questions related to next topics. Private, non-private, void, non-void, parameter, non-parameter methods also you are asking now to implement. No, we will develop topic by topic. First static, non-static, after understanding, then we will modify the code with void, non-void, modify the code with parameter, non-parameter, private, non-private, and final project we will conclude. Understand? Step by step I am going. Don't show your talent. Only my concentration is on method should be static or non-static. That's it. So now this method I am creating as static because inside this method I am accessing bank name only. Next, now below. Static void, branch name, open bracket, closed bracket, system dot, out dot, println of, branch name. Listen, sir, variable name is bank name, method name is also bank name. So what? They are differentiated by parenthesis. If we call bank name only, variable will become. Bank name with parenthesis, method will come. Next, IFSC I want to display separately. Static void, IFSC. ओपन ब्रैकेट क्लोज्ड ब्रैकेट सिस्टम डॉट आउट डॉट प्रिंटलन ऑफ आईएफएससी। ओके, व्हाई आई टेकन ऑल दीज थ्री मेथड्स आर स्टैटिक, बिकॉज इनसाइड दीज मेथड्स वी आर यूजिंग ओनली स्टैटिक वेरिएबल्स। कैन आई क्रिएट देम एज ए नॉन स्टैटिक? Can I create them as a non-static? Can I create them as a non-static? Yes. No compile time error. Okay. But recommended is static. Can I create this method as a static? Can I create this method as a static? No. Compiler will throw error because these three variables are non-static. Have common sense. Try to implement your common sense. Now tell me, sometimes you need complete static non-static values to display, na? For example, you take passbook, unpassbook, static non-static all values of account should be displayed. Then tell me, I want write method name as a display because it is displaying all values. Open bracket, close bracket. This method should be static or non-static. Now inside this method, I am accessing both static and non-static members. This method should be static or non-static? Must be non-static. Then now system dot out dot println of what do you write here? Double quotes bank name plus bank name. I want to take one table and space. Branch name, IFSC. Next, account number. Account holder name, account holder name. Next, balance. Compile successfully because non-static method can access both static and non-static. I have a question, sir. This bank name, branch name, IFSC, are these values reading from object or from the class? First three values are reading from object or class? From class. These three values are reading from object. Wonderful, super. Can I declare this method as static? Can I declare this method as a static? No, compiler will throw error because non-static variables are there. So whatever theory point I have explained, I explained with a sample program. Now I'm explaining with project. Sample program for knowledge, project is for experience. Krishnaveni, all banks are using the same project? Krishnaveni has got a question. Please read, understand. Sir, all banks will use set bank details method with a different bank name. Then how can it be static method? Then bank names will be changing, na? Tell me, are all banks are using same bank? Now tell me, what is HDFC Bank project? HDFCBank.com. This is HDFC Bank project. Come on, can you please access your ICICI Bank account from this project? Krishnaveni, understand? Can you access your ICICI Bank by using this project? No. You will have the same project you are selling to ICICIbank.com separately. Right? ICICIbank.com separately. Okay? Come on. Go and access SBI Bank. Can you access SBI Bank by using these two? No, right? You have to go for another project. SBIBank.com. Rabuji, understand? What is the SBI Bank online or something is there? Okay, Kotak Bank, let me take. KotakBank.com. Hurry. What happened? KotakBank.com not coming. Kotak.com, okay, whatever. So I hope you are following what I'm telling. So we have developed the project one time. We developed the project one time. This project we are selling to every company separately. This project we install in HDFC Bank. Then HDFC Bank, we call set bank details only one time. HDFC Bank details are set. Same project we sell to ICICI Bank. ICICI Bank install this project in his computer and set the bank details ICICI Bank only one time. Separate project, separate JVM, okay? I hope it's clear to you, Nalini. Krishnaveni, sorry, not Nalini, sorry, Krishnaveni. All right, so now, I hope you got clarity on display method. It should be non-static. And here, these three variables are accessed by using class. These three variables are accessed by using object. Now, what I ask you to develop the project, in this project, you must create bank account object with the below details, store the values, read and display values in above variables. You must define methods, okay? Also define business operation methods. These are not business operations. What are the business operations? Withdraw. So generally, after setting the values, we don't read values. We will perform business operation methods. Set values, business operation, last display values. What are the business operations we will do? Deposit. Below. Deposit method should be static or should be non-static? Should be non-static because logic is balance plus amount. Okay, so it should be void deposit. Then there should be a non-static because implicitly it is working with non-static variable. And next, void withdraw of open bracket, closed bracket. It also should be non-static because it is implicitly working with non-static variable. And next, void current balance. Current balance method also must be non-static. Must be non-static method. Why? Because it is implicitly accessing balance variable to display system dot out dot println of balance. Rababu, all people understand that these three are business logic methods. Must be non-static. Can you declare as static? No. Compiler ko. गुस्सा आता तुमको मार दिया स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक वेयर फोर एरर्स नॉन स्टैटिक वेरिएबल बैलेंस कैन नॉट बी रेफरेंस फ्रॉम स्टैटिक कॉन्टेक्स्ट लाइन नंबर 24 बिकॉज स्टैटिक एरर देन नेक्स्ट Line number 24 cannot find symbol balance. BALANCE. Oh. parameter double amount, parameter double amount, compile successful. Okay, is it clear? This is the code you have to develop. I hope, can I hope all the people at least 5-10% you have developed the code. Did you reach at least 5-10%? At least a few methods. At least did you get clarity when to create static method, when to create non-static method. In this program, our target is only understanding when to create static, when to create non-static. Inside, we are accessing only static variables. Inside, we are accessing only static variables. Create method as static. Inside method, we are accessing non-static variables. You must create method as non-static. 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 This idea purpose, okay? Non-static. Now this is static, okay, because only static variable. No non-static variable. If no non-static variable, method should be static. Here we have non-static variables. That's why method is non-static. This idea is needed for you. I will update this project again. Again and again, I'll update this project. Take screenshot. Now I have a question. Now from this bank, I can create multiple bank accounts. Right? Then from which bank, in which bank account, the values are reading and modifying. Now you cannot access the objects directly. You cannot access variables directly, right? Class bank. Copy, save. Bank. And tell me, can I access bank account dot set bank details directly by its name? Double quotes, HDFC, comma, Amirpet, comma, HD 123 AM. Any compile time error? No. Okay. Any runtime error? No. Because this method is static method. Can be accessed by using class name. Then the values are passed to the method parameter. Method parameter values are stored inside class level static variable. When this class is loaded, when you write bank account dot, first this class is loaded into JVM. Allocate memory to static variables. I hope you watched static variables video. Static variables provided a memory when class loaded into JVM. Then method is called. Then method receiving the parameters and copy the parameter values into static variables memory available in the class. Then let me display the values. Bank account dot bank name. If you write parenthesis, it is a method. Now look at there. Is a class again loaded? No. Are static variables memory again allocated? No. Only method is called. Control will go to bank name. In bank name, you are accessing variable bank name. It will go to class level. Bank name, whatever the value you stored, that value will be displayed on the console. What you stored? HDFC. HDFC is coming. Hello? HDFC coming from here? Many students are looking above. Or I passed to HDFC, HDFC displaying. It is depending on the logic you are writing. Here, if you write here in place of, here if you write double quotes, hi, what is the output will come? Hi will come. Method logic, whatever there, that will come. Because you have written here bank name, so that's why whatever the value you passed in above code, that value is coming. Next, now branch name. I'm calling branch name. Now we'll get branch name Amirpet because you pass reading that value, and then IFSC because you pass IFSC method reading IFSC value displaying IFSC. Can you hope understand? All these are static methods. Does you require object for them? No. Why these methods doesn't require object? Because inside these methods we are not accessing any non-static variable. Hello, can I access bank account dot bank account dot display method? Hello, can I call bank account dot display method? No. Compiler throw error because display method is non-static. You create method as a non-static means you're informing to compiler inside method logic I'm accessing non-static variables. Compiler will throw error. Non-static method cannot be referenced from static context. Then what to do? I must create object bank account below account one equal to new bank account. Can I create one more bank account? Yes, bank account, account to do new bank account. This is for HK and this is for BK. Tell me now, I want to execute display method for which object? That object you should write account one dot display below. If I write account one dot display, tell me this account one is applied to bank name? No. Apply to branch name? No. Apply to IFSC? No. Because these are static variables common to all objects. Will it apply to account one? Yes. Account name? Yes. Account balance? Yes. Then currently the values are what? No values. Default values are there. All you people remember, stack class level variables are initialized with the default values. Control one semicolon expected somewhere here. Okay. Control one compiled. Control two executed. Compile. Look at there. Bank name, branch name, IFSC, account name, account holder name, balance. Now I am commenting these lines. Then static variables also will come up with the default value, na? Sorry. I'm commenting this method call. Observe now. Account one dot display. You are getting all default values. Null, 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 zero, null, null, 0.0. If you write account to dot display also in a account to object also, all variables are contain default values only. Then what you'll get? Default values. Sir, am I confusing you, sir? Variables and methods chapter combination. I'm explaining. Any of you are confusing? You must have knowledge on variables and methods. Methods currently we are discussing. You must already practice variables. If not practice, then it creates problem to you. Control one, control two. Account number balance. Okay, so account one object also default values, account two object also default values. Now here bank account dot set balance, if I call this method, I'm setting the static variable values specific to any object? No, I am specifying common to all. Static method is used for executing logic common to all objects. Then when I write control one, control two, look at there, both objects are initialized, both objects are getting static variable values, na? Logic is executed common to both objects. Then next, I am initializing account one object non-static variables. Account one dot set bank details of, bank account details of. Okay, tell me, I am calling set bank account details by using account one. That means this method executed, this method logic executed for account one. Here I am writing अकाउंट 1234 कामा एच के कामा 25,000 कंट्रोल वन कंपाइल सक्सेसफुली एग्जीक्यूट लुक एट देयर ओनली अकाउंट वन वैल्यूज आर इनिशियलाइज्ड Account values are initialized or not initialized? Not initialized. Now my question, I have given a statement. Static method is used for developing logic common to all objects and also executing logic common to all objects. Developing is common, execution is also common. Whereas a non-static method logic, development is common, but execution is specific. And this method is executed for the object using which we call the method. I call with account one, executed with account one. Now I am calling the same method with account two. Logic is the same, but object is different. 5, 6, 7, 8. Mr. Balai Babu, 27,000. Okay, now this clarity you must get yourself. No one can help you. First, you need to get that. You know, you have to connect it to the subject. Static method and non-static method. Both are used for developing logic common to all objects. But static method logic is executed common to all objects. Non-static method logic executed specific to one object with given values. Here non-static method executed for account one. Here non-static method executed for account two. Non-static method logic executed for current object. Okay, na? Is it comfortable to all? Whatever the theory points I have explained here, are all theory points are came into your mind? All these 8 points in a non-static method. If you access non-static variable directly by its name, from where this non-static variable memory is accessed from the current object account one account. Here I set the values. Now let me try to perform business operations. Now I am depositing account one dot. Listen, account one dot set bank details of I'm writing double quotes ICICI. Hey, ICICI SR Nagar double quotes IC 789 SR. Abolo. If you call this method, any affected to account one, account two objects, I call with the account one. Then effect come to account one. Is there any effect to account two? Everyone answer. No effect to account two now. Oh my God. Take one small bucket of water, jump inside that. Okay. Take one bucket of water. Okay. Jump into that bucket of water. Tumri fellows, brainless fellows. 100 times I explain also, 101 time again you will get to come up with your brain. Question yourself. What is this method? Static method. Static method executed common to all objects. If we call static method and modify static variable values using one object, that modification affected to another object also. Stupid fellows. How many times I should repeat same statement again and again? Both objects values will be ICICI Bank. Account one details ICICI. Account two details also ICICI. Adhoi sachinda, understand? Now I'm calling account one dot deposit of 5,000 or 7,000, let's say 7,000. Tell me, I call deposit method by using which object? Account one. Is this deposit 7,000 affected to account two? Why? Deposit method is a non-static method. Inside non-static method, you access only static non-static variables and modifying its value. Is it affected to another method, another object? नो Account one object is 32,000. Earlier, how much? 25. 20 plus 7,000, 32,000. Any affected to account two? No, because every object contains its own copy of variables. Every object contains its own copy of memory. One object memory cannot be affected to another memory. Go back and visualize the memory diagram properly. Static, non-static variables. Practice and remember. Every day you are coming to class just for casually to listen the class. The days are over. Golden days are over. Next, tell me. I'm calling account to two dot withdraw of 5,000. I'm calling withdraw method by using which object? Account to two. Then the modification done in which object? Account to two. Is that modification affected to account one? No. If you give answer as well, I'll come to your home to beat you. Maybe you are thinking that you are away from me. No, I'll come to your home because I am Lord Krishna. Abracadabra, I'll come to your home, stand next to you and beating you and coming back to my home. Tumri fellows. Look at there. There is no effect to account one. Effect to only account to two because you call the method using account to two. Okay, na? Hello, Arjuna. Hello, my dear Arjuna. Understand, Arjuna? I am Lord Krishna, na? You are my Arjuna. Come on, buddy. Simple point. Why you don't want to understand? Why you don't want to remember? Why you don't want to answer correctly? Static variable value common to all objects. If you modify static variable either directly by its name or via method, modification affected to all objects. Non-static variable will have separate copy of memory in every object. If you modify non-static variable either by directly accessing or via method, the modification is applied to only current object, not applied to another objects. This is a simple conclusion point. Will you practice this project? What do you say? Will you practice this project? Take screenshot. I hope you've taken screenshot for bank account already. Bankaccount.java. Now bank.java. Please work out. Please work out. Don't neglect. First you comment it and then uncomment it. Then you will see the difference. Step by step. However I have explained, same way you work. Step by step. Or else you can take like this. You can create these two bank objects at beginning of the class itself. Then you assign, either you read individually or call display method by using I'll call display method several times. You call here default values, then again you call here after static method called modification affected. The next, you cannot call display method directly by its name, right? Then you call account one dot set balance. Okay, set bank account details. Then only account one object affected. After this, again you call. Only affected to account two object. Now modify. Then again display. Then modify. Again display. Then modify. Again display. So for every operation you display, then you will see the clarity. Understand? Please work out this project today, tomorrow. Tomorrow, I'm going to teach you private, non-private, void, non-void, parameter, non-parameterized method. And I'm going to apply all those methods, all those operations here only. In this program only, I'll apply. I'll just enhance them. If you are just a time passing, just coming to class and going without practicing, then you'll face problem. One second. And now you take